Hofbörn, Svein og Spörn Dán. The Amazing Girl Mjöðveig, Róðrekur and Róðúlfur. Róðúlfur and Róðrekur are happy to see Hakne and all the others and greet them heartily. Róðrekur and Róðúlfur used to own a hof, a heathen shrine. Róðúlfur means a famous wolf and Róðrekur famous and powerful. Njörn and Njóla greet them well. Njörn means the strong one related to Njörður. Njóla means knight. What she is doing here is making butter from cream of milk. Njörn, we knew you would be coming. Your fylgja, the followed coming beforehand, the folklore, according to folklore, arrived a little ago, so powerful that we fell asleep and visualized about your arrival. Such foresight is common in Icelandic folklore. On the picture, Snorralaug, Reykholt, where Snorri Sturluson lived. It is good to have a bath after a long journey. We are blessed with warm water here in Iceland, and the bairns are offered good food and offered a good place to sleep if they wish to overnight. Njörn, this little girl is Mjöðveig. It means meat, or veig can be a drink or a vessel, or vje, a holy shrine. Mjöðveig knows by heart long heathen þulur poems, which she can recite for you. Do you want to write them down and save them? We shall do that tonight if you wish us for our amusement before bed. Róðrekur, they burn down our hof, Högni. Hof is a heathen shrine. Engus, this is politics, Róðrekur. Power greed under the false name of goodness. It is obey our rules or die. Róðrekur, they burnt down the hof and everything in it. Róðúlfur, the name of this farm used to be Hofstaðir, but we changed that long ago. Hofstaðir, a farm where a hof heathen shrine is. Hofs common in names of places in Iceland, as there used to be hof there. Names still remain in the many places where there were men who had hof heathen shrine long, long ago. Högni, everything goes in cycles. There are dark ages, but they will pass by. There is fróða friður, as told of in Grottasöngur, Edda poem, and then greed, and abuse of animals, abuse of nature. Fenja, the feathered one, and Menja, the hairy one, are abused by the ignorant ones for easy money gain. Fenja and Menja are the animals we exploit and nature exploited. By man's greed all perishes. Kunni maður mjöt, let men know what is enough. Takki maður ei meir þurrar næfra en þarf. Let men not take more raw material from other nature than necessary. No God gave us the animals of the prairie. Do not believe that. Animals are souls on their evolutionary path. We should not disturb their path by killing them. If man is lord of the earth, then our responsibility is great, our concern and obligations to protect all life. Högni continued, everything goes in cycles. There are dark ages, but they will pass by, and the bright age of enlightenment takes over. There are parts of the day, every part of day and night has a name. Yktir of the day, midnætti or lágnætti, midnight or low night, top of my drawing. Ótta is at 3 o'clock in the morning, miður morgun, mid morning at 6. Dagmál or daybreak at 9. Hádegi, high day or noon, when sun is at highest point on the southern sky, bottom of my drawing. Noon at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, mid aftan, mid evening at 18 o'clock. At 9 o'clock in the evening, náttmál, night time. The cycle lifespan, Icelandic ævi, helja, ævi. Gelgormnes, this knowledge is not allowed under churchianity, as then they cannot rule us by their one lifespan only invention, agreed upon on the churchian assembly some time ago, so that they can rule over man's life and man's death. Edda smál laughs. Edda smá, they are smart indeed in their world rule strategy, frightening men with death. Edda smá continued, I remember past lives. That helps me understand my urður verðandi skuld og karma. Cycles in life move us forward. There is that petty cycle of waking, dreaming, deep sleep, which even if cycling really takes us nowhere, the big cycle of transcending really furthers our spiritual evolution. Sigdrífa, and our seasons are a cycle. Högni, tomorrow we hold a blót outside in Mother Nature. We need no ceiling other than the sky. We should know that tívar are everywhere. We see them not, but they are everywhere in the created universe. Tepla í túni, teitir eru, play happily in the dynamism, tún. Think blót ásatrú manna á þingvöllum. Tívatún, tún of tívar the gods, tún word stem dynamism. Tívar, deva, are the fundamental impulses of creative intelligence. They play happily in the dynamism, tepla í túni, teitir eru. The gods within preside over total natural law. Name of one god is FornSidr. FornSidr means president, president. The gods and the laws of nature are always flawless and they run the whole universe in perfect correlation and orderliness. Ásgarður, tívatún, ragnarsjöt, sver of our gods, unified field of total natural law, is everywhere, is here within, and we live that realm by nýsa niður. We shall learn to understand the connection between the laws of nature, the uncreated, and the created, which also is they. Is their perfect orderliness mirrored in every single wave of creation, in every layer we perceive with our senses? Understand how to recognize the relationship between the unmanifest abstract reality of natural law and its concrete expression at every level of manifestation. Angus, Þingvellir used to be our most sacred place. A dreadful thing happened after churchianization. The church pollutes Þingvellir with executions and they drown at Þingvellir in Öxará, pregnant girls, many of them having been raped. They commit atrocious acts, use atrocity, savagery. Their cruelty is limitless, covered up under their flowery meaningless words. There are many versions of their monogod, old Bible version, Roman version, etc., but that man-made concept is always used to rule. Everything else is banned by penalty of death. Sigdrífa, concepts like the devil did not exist until they imported it, and the word religion did not exist. Hugmóður, that system theocracy is a later time invention in Latin post natus, later born or invented later. Funnily enough, post natus becomes in English the English word puny. Edda smá laughs. Angus, they stole our holidays and changed our hof sites into church sites. Sigdrífa, what we got along with that imported stuff is some hottest hell, but we never understood that devil nor that hell. We never wanted their dedication to suffering. We tend to use these empty words hell and devil in daily language as some spice. Hell we got, hell good things, and devil got, devil good things. Edda smá laughs. And they call that to call the heathen gods, blóta and ragna. Angus, the horror came to Ireland when Patrick imported it working for the Vatican in Rome. He learned how to deceive his good old friends on returning to Ireland, for that they call him a saint. All the time, dominance was their goal, conquests. That is what theocracies are made for. Vatican is a newer name for the Roman Empire. Spiritual evolution of man is not their concern. That is, on the other hand, what heathenry is all about. Njörun, the little girl Mjöðveig, knows many long heathen poems, þulur, which she can recite for you. Högni, we can write down each long þula in this way. Each one of us listens to one vísa verse, memorizes and writes down, in a row. Edda smá the first vísa, Sigdrífa the next one, Gael Gormlech the next, Engus, Húmóður, Högni, æ. And then Edda again and so on. All ready with papyrus and feather to write with. We will have fun and it is good to save these poems. Njóla, one vísa says, Heilög María gaf mér sauð, Holy Mary gave me a fat ram. Datsun yður stunduð, then fell down stone dead. Þá kom hún Freyja, then came Freyja. Hún kann ekki að deyja. She knows not how to die. Edda smá laughs. They all sit down, ready for the long, long poems, and write them down. The bairns memorize and write in a systematic row. This becomes a marvelous evening. This little girl is amazing. Then they will take the poems, þulur, to Bergþór in Bláfell. Bergþór says, Engin frýr Óðsmál græsku, nobody claims malice to be contained in Óðsmál. En meir eru þau grunuð vit, but the more Óðsmál is claimed to be full of wit and wisdom. Icelandic saga, no one sees thee lacking intelligence, but the more thou might be suspected of vicious malice. Bergþórs continued, Why would we try to understand Óðsmál? Because Óðsmál is full of good theories, new explanations, good intuition. Allegory and symbolic language is explained, pure theosophy and heathenry here understood. Óðsmál brings profound understanding, we gain the knowledge. Perhaps we have not fathomed the profound understanding before. We understand concepts intellectually, no illiteracy anymore. Understand why men live a life. Do men know the purpose of being born and then live? Men learn to nýsa niður, so that every man can go on his evolutionary path.